Hello everyone, my name is Ricardo Mimos. In this series of videos, I will be demonstrating how to use Update Service to set up the offline POS using the new web replication with Azure Storage. In this video, I'm covering the last installation step that is about setting up the offline POS. In the previous videos, you have seen how to set up Update Service Server and how to go through the steps to create the offline POS installer. After downloading the offline POS installer from your Update Service Server, you need to copy it to the POS terminal. For the purpose of this video, I have created a virtual machine on Azure and I have copied the installer to this folder. To set up the offline POS, you need to run the installer and don't forget it to run it as an administrator. In this step, click on Install to install the POS bundle. I don't have any SQL Server instance installed in this virtual machine, so I'll tick this option to install a SQL Server Express instance. Follow this step according to your requirements and click on Next. Here you have a list of parameters for the different packages to be installed. Parameters related to SQL Server Express, to the Business Central Web Client, and so on. Most likely you should be fine with the default values, but feel free to update these parameters according to your requirements. In the bottom, there are three fields related to the Azure Storage Replication data package that we provide that needs to be filled in. In the previous videos, I decided not to include the client secrets for the service-to-service user, so I will need to do it when running this installer on the POS. And you need to key in the store number and the distribution location for the POS terminal that's being configured. The store number and the distribution location code must match the ones configured in the head office. Then, click on Next. Here you have the option to list the packages that are going to be installed on the terminal, as well as the arguments that are going to be used for each package. To start the installation, click on Install. All the required packages like SQL Server Express, Business Central Platform, Business Central and LS Central Apps, and so on, will now be downloaded from your Update Service Server to the POS terminal. This step might take some minutes, depending on your internet connection speed. Once the packages have been downloaded, they will be installed, and this step can also take a couple of minutes, depending on the POS terminal specifications. Now the installer is running the data package that will inject the minimum required setup to run the replication in the POS. And also the automatic web services subscription package that will automatically trigger the web services subscription. And now the installation has completed successfully. Next step is for you to access the Business Central instance on the POS. For the purpose of this video, first thing I will do is to check if the web services have actually been subscribed. Let's open the Web Services Setup page and confirm that all the web requests for version 2 web services have been populated. The next step is to run and test the replication job. Let's open the Scheduled Job card and you can see that you already have this Azure Replication Scheduled Job. It has been automatically created by the new data package that we, LS Retail, have created and made available through our public update service server, and that is included in the POS bundle when following our installation guidelines. Please note that prior to running this Azure Storage replication job on the POS, I have run the needed scheduled jobs on the head office to create and send the files with the data to the Azure Storage to be replicated down to the POS. To run the job manually, click on Run Now. When running the Azure Replication job, the POS will trigger a call to the head office asking for new packages to be fetched from the Azure Storage. If there are new packages, then the POS will connect to the Azure Storage, will download the files and apply the data. The replication has completed, and you can now confirm that the data has been replicated to the POS. I will, for example, open the retail items page and check that the retail items are listed here. And that's it for this video. Thank you for watching.